Hi, I'm Delita Williams, and I am a parish nurse, and I am over the health ministry here at Anniston Full Gospel Holy Temple. And so today we wanted to talk to you a little bit about what is nutrition. During the pandemic, a lot of the focus has been on safety and COVID-19 prevention, quarantine, reinforcing social distancing, good hand hygiene, and masking. And when I listen to all that is being said, there has not been a lot of emphasis placed on our nutrition. And during this time, that is very important, because if our bodies are nourished properly, then we're in a better position to fight diseases as they come upon us. And so we use medicine, and that's fine, but our bodies also need to be able to utilize the medicine and utilize the defenses which God has placed in our bodies to help us to fight these diseases. So we want to talk a little bit about nutrition. Nutrition is how food affects the health of the body, and it's comprised of different components. You got your macronutrients, which is your proteins, your carbohydrates, and your fat. And so those are specific major nutrients which causes the body to grow and to function properly. And it gives us our energy. And helps us to maintain good health. So nutrition is very important. I know you've heard a lot of times, you are what you eat. And if you eat junk, you're junk. And that's not talking about junk in terms of you're nothing. But when you don't properly feed the body, then what happens is the body is not fit to really take care of itself in the case of disease, sickness, illness, infection, those kinds of things. When we talk about nutrition, we talk about the intake of food, considered in relationship to the dietary needs. All that is saying is that you're taking in enough food to really fuel the body for what it needs. Everybody's need is not the same. Some people have very high metabolisms and they just use all that food up very quickly, so they may need a little bit of extra food. Some of us have slow metabolisms. We don't really utilize the food as quickly. It stays a little bit longer, so we may have less food. The bottom line is that we are giving our bodies the adequate amount of nutrients that it needs. When we talk about good nutrition, we're talking about an adequate amount of food, a well-balanced intake of food. I don't like using diet because everybody associates diets with different ones like the keto diet or the Mediterranean diet. But basically what you want to do is have a well-balanced nutritional plan, and you want it to be adequate for what your body needs. And then you combine that with physical activity, and that is the cornerstone of good health. As in my profession, I deal a lot with people who have diabetes, and so they're either on like medicines by mouth, or they may be on insulin shots, or they may have a combination of both. And a lot of times they'll come in and they'll say, you know, I need to up my blood sugar medicine. And I'm like, okay, what are you eating? Okay, tell me about your nutritional plan. And so that's a very important part of our makeup, not just in helping us to handle anything that attacks the body, but it is also very good in our maintenance of our disease process. So good nutrition is very important. Of course, your poor nutrition can lead to reduced immunity. You're more susceptible to diseases, impaired physical and mental development, and reduced productivity. It's very important that we eat the right way in order to, especially children, for their growth and development. But even as adults, there are certain areas that we need to maintain when we look at good bone structure, good muscular tone. And so it's just very important that we as adults also learn to eat very nutritiously. The diet of an organism is what it eats. And that's what I say. You've heard that term. If you eat junk, you're junk. If you eat well, you're good. And it just means that it's just how you eat and what's in your body and what your body has to use. A healthy nutritional plan includes the preparation of food, the storage method that preserves the nutrients, and the heating and that reduce the risk of foodborne illnesses. So there's a lot. It sounds like a lot, but it's basically telling you that the food that you have to make sure that number one, it's in good condition. Number two, that it is stored properly. And number three, that it is cooked properly. Eating a healthy nutritional plan has been shown over and over again to prevent a variety of illnesses. And I know a lot of people don't believe that, but it can. All right, a lot of people, and it's not everybody, a lot of people that have diabetes, for instance, since that is something that I work with day in and day out, a lot of times they have the they're developed diabetes because of the way they eat and the inactivity. Now, a lot of people attribute that to eating a lot of sweets, and that's true. But you can eat a lot of high carbohydrate foods, like a lot of starches, like a lot of potatoes, a lot of beans, a lot of corn, a lot of peas, a lot of bread, a lot of rice, a lot of pasta. And that, when you eat too much of that, then what it does is it increases your carbohydrate intake. And so then, of course, the carbohydrates break down to sugar. That's all sugar is. It's just a breakdown of carbohydrates. And then, of course, it gets in the bloodstream. And then, of course, if we try to get it out, the body on its own, because your body does make insulin. But if you have too much of that, then the body's overwhelmed. So that's why we say, you know, over and over again, we have shown that eating the right kinds of things and feeding your body well can help reduce or even prevent a lot of diseases. One of the other things that we deal with a lot is, like, a lot of people with the colon cancer, you know, we're telling people, you know, eat a lot of fiber, eat a lot of fruits and a lot of vegetables. So what you want to do is, when you eat, you don't want that food to stay in there and stagnate. You want to release it. That's what it's supposed to do. A lot of people don't understand what the purpose of digestion is. So when food is good, and so when you eat the food, what you want it to do is you want it to go ahead and be processed by the body. You want it to absorb all the nutrients and the vitamins and minerals that it needs, but what isn't needed, you want to go ahead and rid the body of that. And a lot of times that's not done, and so it just kind of stagnates in there and develop into different things. You know, you can have polyps, you know, diverticulosis, diverticulitis, even colon cancer. So that's why it's important that you eat really well. High fiber and fruits and vegetables are good for helping the body to be efficient in its digestive process. So we know that over and over and over again, it has been proven. If you eat well, I'm not saying you will be totally disease free, but we do know that if you eat well, that you can prevent a lot of things that happens from happening. We realize that some things are just genetics. We can't change that. But the thing of it is, even if you don't prevent it, it can be maintained just with adequate nutrition. So I want to break down a few little things to you about nutrition. There are seven major classes of nutrition. There's your carbohydrates, your fats, your fiber, your minerals, your protein, your vitamin, and guess what? Yes, water. What we don't always drink a lot of. Now, the main source of energy for the body is the carbohydrates. So that's why sometimes you have to be careful when you are decreasing your carbohydrates, because that is your main source of energy. Then you've got fats. And a lot of people think, oh, we don't want all that fat because of the high cholesterol. But it is also a source of energy. And it is also important in relationship to fat-soluble vitamins. Now, a lot of people don't understand that fat is necessary, but we just don't want you eating the bad fats. If you ever talk to the doctor about your cholesterol, he'll talk to you about your LDLs. But there's another cholesterol that is really good, and that's your HDLs. Now, your LDLs are what we call low density lipoprotein. There are too much fat. But then you have your HDLs, which need to be good too. And those are the good fats. So you have LDLs, bad fat, HDLs, good fat. So fat is very important. You just want more of the good fat. Then you have your roughage or your fiber. And that is in the digestible part of our diet that's essential to the digestive system. What that does, you get that bulk in there, and then what the body doesn't use, then you're able to flush it out by elimination. Okay, so it is very important to help the body rid itself of the unnecessary leftovers, should we say, of the food. Okay, then you've got your minerals. These occur in the body, and they are critical for normal function. And sometimes people take over the counter minerals, but you can get minerals from just eating the proper type of food. And then you have your protein. Now, we know protein is essential to growth and repair of muscles and other body tissue. You see the bodybuilders, they have to eat all this protein, the bulk up. So protein is very, very, very essential. And then you have your vitamins. You have water soluble vitamins, and then you have fat soluble vitamins. But they're all important in the chemical processes that take that are taken in the body, and water. 60% of your body makeup is water. Okay, so water is essential to normal body function. It is a vehicle for carrying other nutrients throughout the body. Water is just so important. People typically don't really understand the importance of water, but it is essential in all of the body processes, in keeping your kidneys function and bathing your organs and getting rid of necessary foods or toxins. That water is very good. It's good for your skin. It makes your skin look better. It avoids you from being dehydrated because you're giving the body the adequate amount of liquids that you need. And a lot of people say, well, I can't drink water, so I drink Coke or they drink tea and things like that. But your body needs water. Now, the other things are fluids too, but you need to drink a lot of waters, okay? And so these are the nutrients that we need to keep us healthy. Now, when I looked at WHO, which is the World Health Organization, their statement says, nutrition is a critical part of health and development. Better nutrition is related to improved infant, child, and maternal health, stronger immune systems, safer pregnancies and childbirth, lower risk of non-communicable diseases such as diabetes and cardiovascular disease, and longevity. So, nutrition is very, very important. I think we've done so much focus on everything else that is going on in the world that we fail to put a lot of emphasis on nutrition, because if our bodies are well fed, then they can help fight off the diseases, the infections, the viruses, the bacterials that we experience from day to day. So good eating is very essential to us. It is not difficult. It can be less expensive. I deal with people all the time who may be on a fixed income, but I can, with any income that you have, I can pretty much show you how to eat right. And it's not, you don't, A lot of people go on specialized diets. That's fine if that works for them. But if you eat nutritionally the way that the guideline has been set up, then you would be able to fight different diseases that come upon you and even prevent some from happening. So we just need to learn to really focus more on what we eat. If anything we should take away from this pandemic is the importance of having our bodies in good shape to fight the germs, okay? That we should take that away more so than anything, because the better fit you are nutritionally, the better able your body can fight off the diseases that come upon you. I'm not saying you might not need medicines or different help from the medical staff, but what I'm saying, you're in a better position to fight because your body is strong. Just like a boxer trains and builds up his body so that he will be able to take on his opponent and become the champion, so is what we do in terms of nutritional eating. If we eat the way we should, so that we can build up our immune system, so that we can prepare our body for what is to come upon it, we would be in a much better situation. A lot of times we don't think about eating as important until we're trying to lose weight. But it's important that we eat nutritionally even when we're not trying to lose weight, okay? It's important that we eat that way because the body is designed. I tell people this all the time. Your body is designed to take care of itself. It's up to you to provide it with the fuel that it needs to do what it has been designed to do. A lot of things that we take by mouth, the body has already been fortified with it. It's just that there are times that it gets overwhelmed and it needs that little bit of help. I always tell people God has really fitly, delicately, and intricately put this body together. He has provided in our bodies those things that are necessary to fight. We have germ fighters. We have blood clotters. We have blood thinners. We have all that we need. But we as individuals have to take care of our body and provide the nutrients to help these processes to be more effective and efficient in helping us. And so that's why it's so important that we eat. One of the things in doing some research during the COVID-19, which I've done a lot of research in as far as nutrition is concerned, to help us to fight the COVID-19, one thing I came across, which I thought was very interesting, and I'd like to share this with you, and it is talking about nitric oxide. And I never really thought about this in terms of our body function, okay? But nitrous oxide disrupts the virus of ability to grow. If you've ever heard me talk about viruses, once they find a host, they're able to proliferate or spread or make more of them. And if you've listened to with the COVID-19, you hear the term variants, 7 variants, and now they're finding another variant. So this just means that viruses know how to manipulate themselves so that when you try to stop it one way, they make a different version of themselves so that they can keep growing and spreading. And so nitrous oxide has the ability to stunt the growth of viruses. So what is nitric oxide? It's used by the body cells for signaling, blood vessels dilation to promote better blood flow. And there's even evidence that it helps with lowering the blood pressure, helping the brain, function better. But it also can boost our immune system because it has that signaling power to the body. So when I was researching this, I found five top sources of nitric oxide foods. One of them was beetroot juice. Okay, now a lot of people don't like beets. I had a patient of mine, he was drinking a lot of beet root juice, and of course it was a little sugary, so it kind of it changed some of the dynamics of his blood work. But in moderation, beets have a lot of nitrates in them, which the body converts to nitric oxide. Now, I had a salad today and I loaded them with beets. I love beets. They're good to me. A lot of people don't, but they do contain a lot of nitrates, which can convert over to the nitric oxide. So they're very good source of nitric oxide foods, which can help with the COVID-19. Also garlic. We all know about garlic. It is wonderful seasoning, and it's just going back to basic herbs and spices. Garlic is very good. It's good for a lot of things, but it also is used in activating the synthesis or the making of nitric oxide. So we know garlic is really good. Leafy green vegetables, wonderful, wonderful. Kale, broccoli, cabbage, spinach, celery, arugula, these are packed with nitrites, which also do the same thing. They convert over to the nitric oxide in your body. Very good source. Citrus fruits, and we know those, oranges and lemons and limes and grapefruit. The only thing I do caution people about, when you get into citrus fruits, you have to be a little careful, because sometimes too much of them can create a lot of acid. But we all know that vitamin C from the citrus fruit plays a critical role in health and in the immune system. Nuts and seeds. I know you've heard a lot about almonds and cashews and walnuts and flax seeds. I have a lot of people that take flax seeds by pills. Pumpkin seeds, sunflower seeds. These are also very good in helping with the nitric oxide production in your body. So it's, you know, if you notice, I covered a well-rounded area of foods, okay? So when we're talking about a good nutritional plan, a well-balanced plan, we're talking about incorporating protein, carbohydrates, and fats, as they all play an individual part in maintaining balance in our bodies. But more specifically, certain foods like lean proteins, fruits, and vegetables may be important when to target when optimizing your nutrition for healing or infection prevention. Those are very good, and we push that. A lot of proteins, fruits, and vegetables. the protein need for those at highest risk are already greater due to their history of chronic illness or age. So if you want to protect and support lean muscle, you may need to choose good sources of protein, chicken and turkey, seafood, plant-based options like beans and nuts, legumes. Beans are really a good source of protein. I can remember because I grew up in older times where sometimes they would make cook a pot of beans and have some greens and some cornbread, and only meat sometimes, maybe the meat that was in the beans, but the beans were still giving you the protein. And so protein is very important. The other thing is fruits and vegetables. Oh my goodness, I cannot stress the importance of fruits and vegetables. There are a lot of people, well, I don't like this vegetable, I don't like that vegetable. But fruits and vegetables are very important in helping the body to run efficiently and effectively and keeping you nice and clean and making you think better and making your heart function better. It's very, very good. Your fruits and your vegetables produce your vitamins that are necessary. And so it's so important to eat that. And if you don't know, with 70% of the immunity being in your gut, when we're talking about in the digestive system, it is also good to keep your healthy bacteria thriving. A lot of people don't understand that your body has bacteria. It has good bacteria, especially in the gut, and it's necessary for the digestion of food. And you want to keep that thriving. You don't want the bad bacteria to overtake the good bacteria. And then the other thing is sometimes it's just better to eat smaller meals, but eat more frequently, especially if you're not as active as you usually are. Right now, more people, well, it's getting a little bit better, but during the heat of the COVID crisis, people were locked down. They were in their houses. They weren't out as much, and so they tend to eat more and move less. And so when you are not as active as you can be, then you need to eat smaller meals. You can eat them more frequently, but just eat smaller meals. This is one of the things that we teach people with diabetes, because sometimes they say, well, I don't have time to eat, or I just don't eat like that. And where we would prefer they eat like three regular meals, sometimes they can't. So we tell them, eat smaller meals, just eat more frequently. And that will help you to maintain a good blood sugar. And of course, drink plenty of water. Stay hydrated. It is not only is it good for overall fighting infection, but it helps to keep the mucus thin and easier to remove from your body. I don't know if you've had your doctor tell you when you was, you know, may have a cold. I know we do a lot. We tell people to use Mucinex because it kind of breaks up that congestion, but then you have to drink a lot of water because it'll break it up. But then if you drink the water, it thins it out, and then you're able to either cough or blow it out more efficiently. So water is very good, unless, you know, and a lot of it is good for you unless you're under a fluid restriction. A lot of water helps with elimination. You know, when you eat, it helps your body to get rid of the unnecessary, undigested food. So water is very, very good. It helps the kidneys to function and get rid of unwanted waste and toxins in the body. So nutrition is everything. You know, you take the medicines, you do what the doctor says, but you still need to equip your body with what it needs to help you to fight, because medicine alone is not going to be everything to help your body fight. Your body has to be in a condition, even with the medicine, fighting off the germs and the illness and the infections that you are experiencing. So nutrition is just, I mean, to me, it's priority. I mask, I wash my hands, I social distance, but I've made it a point to make sure that I am nutritionally fit. So when you're shopping, try to get foods that are high in vitamin A. Sweet potatoes, delicious. Spinach, carrots, cantaloupe, red peppers, okay, mangoes. Vitamin C, same thing. And everybody knows oranges and strawberries. Brussels sprouts, grapefruits, cauliflower. Foods that are high in vitamin D, tuna fish, mushroom, milk, yogurt, eggs, orange juice, sardines, salmon, oh, really good. Top vitamin E foods, sunflower seeds, almonds, hazelnut, peanut butter, nothing like peanut butter crackers. Okay, spinach, sunflowers, and I'm just naming a few. And now I know a lot of people have gone to taking zinc during the COVID-19, but some foods that are high in zinc is yogurt, lentils, cashews, pumpkin seeds, beans, chicken, beef. Those things are really, really good in zinc. So what we want you to do is to take care of yourself. Now, what is a good balanced diet or nutritional plan? What do we consider good balance nutritional plan? Well, I'm gonna say, I tell you what we use, and we use this a lot with people who have diabetes, but it works for everybody, because we use it on people who are trying to either lose weight, maintain weight, or just say, I want to be healthy. When you're looking at your plate, half of your plate should be non-starchy vegetables. Half of your plate. So what are we talking about? We're talking about greens. We're talking about all kinds of greens like spinach, lettuce, cabbage. We're talking about green beans, okay? We're talking about carrots, green peppers, red peppers, things like the non-starchy vegetables, okay? Then 1/4 of your plate should be meats. So you want to get your lean meats, your less fatty meats, and then the other 1/4 of your plate should be starchy foods, breads. I know a lot of people look down on bread. They look down on potatoes. They look down on rice and pasta, but your body needs those, because those foods, your starchy foods, are what we call complex carbohydrates. The body breaks them down more easily. That's why they tend to raise your blood sugar, because they're broken down more efficiently. And so you still need those. You just need those in smaller amounts than you would do the other food groups. So it's okay to have some rice. It's okay to have some beans. You don't want to have a half a pot of beans. But maybe, you know, a small bowl of beans or small cup. It's okay to have pasta. You can take like maybe a cup of pasta and add some carrots and some celery, some cauliflower, some broccoli, some onions. And by the time you add all of that, you have from a cup, you have a big old bowl. So that's what you want to do. The other thing too is you want to incorporate your milk products. Some people can't drink regular milk, so they have almond milk. I know one lady drinks what they call Fairlight milk because she has a sensitivity to milk. And we really would love when you do the milk to not drink anything higher than 2%. A lot of people don't like skim milk, but 1% to 2%, that's what we suggest. And then the other group would be your fruits and your vegetable. I mean, your fruits, because we've already included the vegetables. So that makes up your whole meal plan. And it doesn't take a lot. It just takes diligence. It takes a determination that I've got to change what I do. What we start with when we're trying to incorporate foods that people don't typically eat is there has to be a mindset change first. And so you have to realize that I'm doing this for my good so that I will be better. Then you want to incorporate changes one meal at a time. So if you're used to eating a lot of food at breakfast that overwhelms the body, then you might want to start with breakfast. That may be your trigger meal, okay? So you may want to start trying to redo your breakfast so you incorporate. I mean, you can have grits and you can have eggs. And I even do bacon. I just do it in the microwave and make it real crispy. But you start there trying to minimize the amount of what you're eating. One thing I do teach people about when they're making changes, especially at breakfast, you know, when we eat breakfast, if you like me, a breakfast lover, you eat, you know, you like the eggs, the grits, and toast, and the bacon. Some people like sausage, whatever that meat would be. But if you're eating grits, you don't need toast. If you're eating toast, you don't need grits because you got all that starch. So you just kind of compromise with your meal. You can eat anything you want to. The goal is moderation. You eat it, but you eat it in moderation. Okay, even the sweets that you eat, moderation. I had a patient I was teaching, and he loved Snickers, and he had diabetes. So we compromised, and what we did is we bought the fun size bags of Snickers. And we started off with him having maybe one or two a week, okay? Just to see how it would do, okay? And that was satisfying, and we were able to maintain his blood sugar. So you can do those little compromises with yourself in order to make yourself more healthy. Your health is going to be of utmost importance to you. Longevity is based on your health. If you're healthy, then you have a better chance of fighting a lot of things that happen to you. You can avoid the heart attack, the strokes, the diabetes, some of the cancers. Some things are not avoidable, and I understand that. But it is God's will that we prosper and be in good health, even as our soul prosper. And the Bible teaches me, if I do what He has commanded me to do and be a good steward over my body, that my health shall spring forth speedily. It does not mean that you will never be sick. It does not mean that things won't happen, but you will be in a better position to fight the things that go wrong in the body. So be a more healthy you. Boost up. Eat more vegetables. Eat more fruit. Drink more water. That is where we see the biggest deficiency in the fact that those things are not done in the magnitude that they should be. Take the time to take care of you. And above all, be active. It doesn't mean running a 5K. It just means walking. Maybe outside in your yard. Maybe around the grounds at your apartment. Maybe around the lake. Maybe in the neighborhood. Just don't be a couch potato. Be a healthier you. Eat healthy. Be healthy. Think healthy. Live healthy. God bless you. And be safe.